Whenever you're ready.
How y'all doing? I'm Harris Black, and this is my persuasive speech, Quick Sensation Success. According to Medical News Today website, updated in 2016, smokers' mortality rate are nearly 3 times greater than those of non-smokers, and essentially greater between men and women. Excuse me. This is a representation of a current smoker's mortality rate and a non-smoker's mortality rate between women and men. The problem and the solution. What's wrong? Students at Wake, despite health risks, continue to smoke. How can we fix it? We can fix it by creating a Wake Cessation Program. According to ABC News website updated in 2016, one in every three college students smoke. So take a look around. That is one in every three of us. According to Harvard website, the majority of teen smokers begin smoking at a young age, typically at 14 years old. I have a younger sister, and maybe some of you guys have younger siblings, and that will be looked down upon in my household. Not only is it a illegal thing for minors to smoke, but the health risks that follow may be detrimental to one's health. This slide. Many students consider themselves casual smokers or believe that casual smoking is a casual behavior. This slide is a representation provided by the University of Missouri and is a percent of anchoring events that students smoke. Partying holds the highest percentage, coming in at 18%. Now here are some of the health risks that can follow smoking, according to DermNet's website updated in 2016. As you can see, smoking can cause gum disease, and this is a representation of a smoker's teeth and a non-smoker's teeth. Also, smoking can cause aging of the skin, and it reduces blood cells and vitamin A levels, causing skin to be less moist and very dry. As you can see on the right, that's a smoker's skin. Last but not least, smoking can also cause user to inhale dangerous toxins such as formaldehyde, which is used to embalm deceased bodies, as well as can include cancerous effects. Now, how can Wake help, you may ask? Wake can help by implementing a program that includes encouraging factors to help students, faculty, and staff quit smoking. According to Wake Forest University website, updated in 2016, Thrive's 8-dimensional act, emotional, intellectual, social, spiritual, environmental, occupational, as well as physical well-being can create a cessation program focusing on the physical well-being aspect, and that is health. Washington College's cessation program is considered to be one of the best in the nation, with one in every 7 students who smoke on their campus, according to Washington College website updated in 2016. This is a lot lower than the national average of 1 in 3. How would it work at Wake? Actually, their program includes, Washington College's program includes classes targeted for young adults taught by professional quit coaches, and also offer student therapy as well as free nicotine patches, gum, etc. And it's funded by the health department. Their program normalizes non-smoking on their campus and is succeeding with above average numbers. How can it work at Wake? This can work at Wake by student health teaming up with Thrive to promote student physical well-being, physical health. Also, following through with the cessation program could be a step in putting down cigarettes on campus, using similar tactics to those for Washington College. Okay. This is my counter-argument now, and maybe some of you may say that a cessation program might not be a wise decision or investment depending on how hard it is to quit. This slide shows that in 2014, 37% of smokers who attempted to quit, only 19% of them were successful. So let's put that into perspective. Out of 100 smokers, 37 tried to quit. So of these, only seven were actually successful on their first try. It's not a lot. But according to Tobacco Technical Assistance Consortium, programs specifically targeted to college students committed to Thrive's 8-Dimensional Act would invest in students' physical well-being by creating a cessation program. So therefore, if Wake wants a healthier student body as well as campus, this is a possible solution to help cease smoking. By implementing these factors, such as the cessation classes, as well as informing smokers the risk that smoking can have a positive impact on the health of Wake Forest students, faculty, and staff, it can work here because it has worked anywhere else, so why not choose health? That's my point.